Now let us see how to minimize a given DFA. See, before this video, we have already done how to convert an NFA to a DFA. We've already done how to convert an epsilon NFA to an NFA. Right, NFA means non-deterministic finite automata and DFA means deterministic finite automata. Now, I told you in the previous video that if you are going to convert an NFA to a DFA, then it does not guarantee that you are going to get a DFA which is minimized. Right, in some cases also what happens is it is very difficult to draw a minimized DFA in all the cases. Right, in most of the cases you may be struggling in drawing a minimized DFA. So it becomes very important that you should know an algorithm where you can use that particular algorithm to minimize a DFA so that you can get minimum number of states. And when I'm going to minimize a given DFA, minimization means you are going to create some kind of method so that you can differentiate between states of a DFA. Differentiate between states. For example, you already differentiate between a non-final state and a final state. Right, you know that non-final state is generally represented as a non-accepting state. Non-accepting state. And you know a final state is generally represented an accepting state. This is a basic thing, right? Just like you already know, like in your that this is an accepting state, this is a non-accepting state. Now, when we are going to minimize a given DFA, that means we want to identify that whether you will be able to differentiate between two states or not. Right, given some length of a string, for example, you can give a string of length 1, you can take a string of length 2, you can take a string of length 3. Can you actually differentiate between two states of a DFA? That is a really important thing to know, and we are going to use that concept to minimize any given DFA. Let me show this thing to you with a very simple example. Assume we want to draw a DFA for the language L is equal to W such that length of W mod 2 is congruent to 0 mod 2. We have already done this example and we know this is representing a string whose length is always even, because 0 mod 2 means the length is always even. So how can you do it? See, this is the initial state, which is A. An initial state is actually representing a state which is also a final state. And then if you get a string over A comma B, for example, here summation is equal to A comma B. Let us assume we are only going for to draw for a single symbol. So that is summation is equal to single A. So that means the length of the string becomes odd. And again, you get one more A, then you'll get a length of string which is again even. You'll give one more A, then again you'll get a length of string which is odd. You'll give one more A, again you're going to get a length of string which is even. And so on. And so on. Right, for simplicity, let us say we are going to draw a loop here. Because we cannot draw infinite number of states here. So let us assume we are going to draw a loop like this. Now imagine the scenario that your main aim to identify that whether two states are different or not. Whether two states are different or not. Different means can you differentiate between them? If you can differentiate between them, obviously you can say these two states are representing two different things. For example, here the set of states which is representing a accepting state, for example, the state A, the state B and the state D, they are representing an accepting state here for this given DFA. And if you discuss about the state B and state C, they are non-accepting state here. And there's a basic difference between accepting state and non-accepting state. I should give it some other name. For example, this is state E. Right, so this is E and C. Okay, so there's a basic difference between accepting and non-accepting state. You already know that one rejects the string, one accepts the string. So these two states are actually different. Now, if you get some states in one single set, for example, here we are having three states in one single set, and here we are having two states in one single set. if you are having some states in one single set, then you want to know, can you differentiate between these states? Can you actually differentiate? So for differentiating, you need to know that how can you differentiate, give some strings to these states and identify, are these strings going to different path? For example, if I say initially E and C are same, if I give a string A to E and if I give a string A to C, can they lead you to two different states? If they can lead you to two different states, obviously these states are actually different. Okay, for that purposes, let us draw a state transition table here. Here the only symbol is A, and this is A, B, C, D, and E. These are the four states here. Okay, this is the initial state and the final state. B is representing a final state. D is representing a final state for the above diagram. So I've drawn E here, so I've written E here. If you give a symbol A to A, then you go to E. If you give a symbol A to B, you go to C. If you give a symbol A to D, you go to C, you go to D. If you give a symbol A to D, you go to C. If you give a to E, you go to A. Now this is representing the next states in the state table. Now let us take these states, right? So currently they are called as zero equivalent states. Zero equivalent states. When I'm saying zero equivalent means, can you differentiate between the states by giving a string of length zero, right? By giving a string of length zero, you can differentiate them like this, that one is a set of non-final state and second is a set of final state. Now, can you differentiate between the states? If you give a string of length one, that means, can you differentiate them with a one equivalent state? How do you do it? Take states from one set. For example, take E and C. If you give single A to E, then you are going to the state A. If you give single A to C, then you are going to state D. Now the next states are A and D. Can you differentiate between A and D? Right, but here you can say A and D both are final states. So in the previous set, you cannot differentiate between A and D. Therefore, the next states are same and next state is representing final state. So you cannot, differentiate between E and C with having a string of length one. Now, if you take the symbol A and B, right, if you discuss about A and B, if you give a symbol A to A, then you are going to the state E. And if you give a symbol A to B, then you are going to state C. Now this E and C both are non-final states. You cannot differentiate between E and C as of now. In future, maybe you will differentiate, but as of now, you cannot differentiate between E and C. Therefore, A and B both are actually one equivalent. Now let us see, can D and B be one equivalent? See, if you can prove that B and D are one equivalent, and we already know that A and B are one equivalent, therefore D and A both will become one equivalent. Let us check B and D. If you give A to B, then you are going to go to C. If you give A to D, then you are going to go to the state which is C. So both states are same, therefore you cannot differentiate between B and D, therefore B and D are in the same state. Now you can see in the zero equivalent state and one equivalent state, there is no change. No change means you cannot distinguish between them by giving a string of length one, right? And general tendency is, even if you give a string of length two, you will not be able to differentiate between them. So here E and C, both the states are actually representing the same thing. And here A, B and D, all these states are actually representing the same thing, right? You cannot differentiate between them. Therefore, you can combine the states which are EC and you can combine the states which are A, B and D. Here A, B and D all are representing the final states. Therefore, this will become a final state. Initial state was A, therefore this will become an initial state. Now if you give single A to A, then you go to E, right? Even if you give single A to B, you go to C. If you give single A to D, you go to C. Again, if you on A and C, if you give single A, then you are going to either one of the states, which is A, B and D. Right, so you can see this above diagram, the complete diagram, can be minimized to form this smaller diagram. Right, see, I know that this is not a very good example, But I could take this example just to tell you that what do I mean to say when I'm saying zero equivalence, and what do I mean to say when I'm saying one equivalence, what do I mean to say when I'm saying two equivalence. I'll take some examples, and then using those examples, I'll tell you what is the difference between these states. Okay, between one equivalent, two equivalent, three equivalent, and so on. And then we'll see how can you minimize a given DFA. Assume you are having the following DFA. So this is a state Q naught. Let me draw it here because it will take some time to draw. You also draw in your notebooks, that will be better. See, whatever I'm going to teach you here, it is better to make notes with it, because if you make notes with it, then you will be able to retain it for a longer duration of time. And retaining is one of the biggest problem with the gate examination, because the number of subjects are so long that your memory actually acts as a cache memory. That means you study things, you remember, you try to remember things, but you'll not be able to retain them for a longer duration of time. So it is better to revise regularly, and it is better to do as much practice as possible. So I've taken this example from the book, which is A. Puntam Baker. You can use this book for your practice. I found it as very useful as compared to other books. See, this is an Indian author book. It is not a standard author. But why I'm suggesting this Indian author? Because I've seen some of the concepts which are explained in a really easy manner, the way I'm going to explain here. So this exact same way methodology is used in the book. Okay, so let us assume we are having this given DFA. So it's almost done, don't worry. Don't be scared. Okay, fine, good. See, let me tell you a very interesting story before actually studying this. When I was preparing for gate examination, I was not having this subject theory of computation during my BTEC. So, I could not even get the subject when I was studying it for the first time, and almost 70-80% of my classmates in coaching, they failed to understand this subject, maybe due to the faculty or so. So I used to sit in the last bench, and when I used to sit in the last bench, generally I used to play this game which is cross and so on. So the faculty generally says, we go to Q2, straight Q2. I used to wonder, what is Q2? Is he calling a student as QT or Q2 and so on? So, I consider it as QT, Q2, right? The state Q2. So now I know what is the state Q2. Anyway, that is a PJ. Poor joke. Okay, fine. So let us suppose we are having the following DFA. Now, if you want to minimize the following DFA, then number one, you need to understand the basic principles behind minimizing. And the basic principles which I explained to you in the previous video. Now, first of all, if you can see the above DFA, first of all, you have to identify, are there any states in the DFA which are not reachable? If you cannot reach a state in a given DFA in any possible combination of the strings, is it actually necessary to keep those strings, right? It is kind of waste of your space and waste of your time. So in the above diagram, see if you can, if there's any state which is not reachable, right? So you can see there's a state which is Q4, the state which is Q5, the state which is Q6, the state which is Q7. Even if you give any possible string to the starting state, you will not be able to reach these states. So these states are actually waste of time, they are not useful. So whenever you are going to minimize a given DFA, therefore the first step will be to remove unreachable states. So first step will be remove the unreachable states, okay. Now the second step will be to all the states which are left after removing the unreachable states, right? So let me draw it here. So the states here, you can see all the states which are left after removing the unreachable states, you want to identify whether you can create a difference between two states or not, or you can say whether you can differentiate between two states or not. For that purpose, let us draw the state transition table. See, without even doing the state transition table, you can solve it, but I'll be just giving you a simple quantitative method here. So let us see. Here the initial state is Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3, and Q3 is the final state. If you give a single A to Q0, you go to the state Q1. If you give a single B to Q0, you go to the state Q0 itself. If you give a single A to Q1, then you go to the state Q0. If you give a single B to Q1, you go to the state which is Q2. Right, so again, if you give a single A to Q2, right, then you go to the state Q3. If you give a single B to Q2, you go to the state Q1. If you give a single A to Q3, then you go to the state Q3 itself. If you give a single B, then you go to the state Q0. This is the given diagram. Now, first of all, let us identify what are zero equivalent states. This is the step 3. Find out zero equivalent states. When I'm saying zero equivalent means, can you differentiate between the strings when you give an input of length 0? So the simplest method of differentiating is take a set which is non-final state, take another set which is representing the set of final states. Here the set of non-final states are Q0, Q1, Q2, and the set of final state is actually only Q3. Now let us identify what are the states which are representing one equivalence, or you can say one equivalent states. One equivalent means, can you differentiate between the states with length, if you give us a string of length 1. So if you discuss about the state which is Q0 and Q1, now if you give a symbol A to Q0, you go to the state Q1. If you give a symbol C, let me write it here like this. If you give a symbol A to Q0, you go to the state Q1. If you give a single A to Q1, you go to the state Q0. But here you can see Q0 and Q1 both are in the same set. That means you cannot differentiate between them in the previous case. So Q0 and Q1, in case of single A, you cannot differentiate. But if you give a symbol B, that means if you give B to Q0, you go to the state Q0 itself. If you give B to Q1, you go to the state Q2. And you cannot differentiate between Q0 and Q2 from the previous case. Therefore, Q0 and Q1 both are one equivalent. Now let us look at the state which is Q2 and Q1. Now Q2 and Q1, if you give a symbol A to Q2, you are going to the state Q3. If you give a symbol A to Q1, you are going to the state Q0, and there is a specific difference between Q0 and Q3. Q3 is a final state, therefore it is in the other set, and Q1 is a non-final state, therefore it is another set. Therefore you can actually differentiate between the state which is Q1 and Q2. Therefore Q1 and Q2 will not be one equivalent. See, if Q1 and Q2 becomes one equivalent, then obviously Q2 becomes one equivalent to Q0, right? And if Q2 is not one equivalent to Q1, therefore obviously it is not one equivalent to Q0. Okay, and the different set is Q3. Now let us identify the states which are two equivalent. That means, can you differentiate between the states if you give a string of length 3? See, how I am doing this, a string of length 0 is epsilon, string of length 1 can be A or B, string of length 2 can be AA, or it can be AB, or it can be BA, or it can be BB. String of length 3 can be AAA, AAB, and so on. Right, so this is actually, we are checking in every step, we are checking all the possible cases. Right, so here only check A, here we checked, here we checked epsilon, here we checked AA, here we checked AA, and so on. Right, here we checked 1A. Right, so two equivalent. If you check the state Q0 and Q1, if you give a single A to Q0, you'll get go to the state Q1. If you give a single B A to Q1, then you go to the state Q0. So Q0 and Q1, on giving single A, you cannot differentiate between them. But if you take the symbol B here, and if you give B to Q0, then you'll go to the state which is Q1. If you give B to Q1, you go to the state which is Q2. And Q0 and Q2 both lie in two different sets. Therefore, you can differentiate between Q0 and Q1. So Q0 is different and Q1 is different. And we have the state Q2 and Q3. Okay, fine. So now with length 2 we can differentiate with all the strings, therefore these all the states are actually minimized. Okay, so those who do not understand, let me repeat this everything in Hindi. So agar aapke paas कोई भी दो सिंबल है, जिस तरीके से यहाँ पर मैंने एक सिंबल लिया, एक कोई भी दो स्टेट्स लिए, जैसे यहाँ पर मैंने एक स्टेट थी हमारे पास क्यू नॉट और दूसरी स्टेट थी हमारे पास क्यू वन. हम ये देखना चाहते हैं कि अगर इन दोनों स्टेट्स के अंदर हम सिंबल ए को इनपुट दें तो क्या हम अलग अलग स्टेट्स पर जाएंगे, यानी कि हम कुछ ऐसे स्टेट्स पर जाएंगे जिनके बीच हम डिफ्रेंशिएट कर सकते हैं या नहीं कर सकते. जैसे क्यू नॉट के अंदर अगर हमें सिंगल ए दिया तो हम गए क्यू वन पर, और अगर हमने क्यू वन पर सिंगल ए दिया तो हम गए क्यू नॉट पर. ना Q1 एंड Q0 जो हैं वो दोनों एक ही सेट के अंदर बिलोंग करते हैं यहाँ पर, बिकॉज ये दोनों एक ही सेट के अंदर बिलोंग करते हैं प्रीवियस केस में, देयरफॉर यू कैन से अभी हम इनके बीच में डिफ्रेंशिएट नहीं कर सकते. बट इफ़ यू चेक इन द केस ऑफ B, अगर हमने इन दोनों को सिंबल दिया B, बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट टू क्रिएट अ डिफरेंस ना, सो हमें डिफरेंस क्रिएट करना है. अगर इनको हम B सिंबल देंगे तो Q0 जाएगा स्टेट Q0 के पास एंड Q1 जाएगा स्टेट Q2 के पास, और Q1 Q2 दोनों अलग अलग सेट के अंदर बिलोंग करते हैं, इसी वजह से इन दोनों के बीच में यू कैन डिफरेंशिएट कि भाई Q2 इज अ डिफरेंट स्टेट एंड Q0 इज अ डिफरेंट स्टेट. ओके, देयरफॉर दिस इज डिफरेंट. सो यहाँ पर हमने Q0 और Q1 के बीच में डिफरेंस क्रिएट कर दिया. तो इस तरीके से हमारे पास एक स्टेट आई, स्टेट्स जो आई वो है Q0, Q1, Q2 एंड Q3, एंड ऑल दीज स्टेट्स आर इम्पॉर्टेंट. ऑल दीज स्टेट्स आर इम्पॉर्टेंट, देयरफॉर यू कैन नॉट मिनिमाइज दिस स्मॉलर डायग्राम, बट यू कैन रिमूव दिस सर्किट, दिस रिडंडेंट डायग्राम. सो इफ यू रिमूव दिस रिडंडेंट डायग्राम, सो द कंप्लीट DFA कैन बी मिनिमाइज टू ओनली दिस वन. So this is actually a waste of time. So we can minimize a complete DFA to this smaller DFA, and it is very easy to solve. Okay, let me take few more examples to solve such kind of problems. Okay.